Hey, it's Noctis. Subscribe to Vincent Valentine EX Turk channel.
Got my Archfiends of Chaos. This is your King of Vincent Valentine EX Turk. And I think I'm about to run over my room on my iPhone for the voice recordings. So I might have cut back on this. Now, I said I wasn't going to do this. This is only be a month-by-month basis. But I'm going to do another character ecology. And this is another Final Fantasy 15 one. I know I need to do more Final Fantasies, but until the Final Fantasy 15 hype train runs completely low, and I'm really saving the Vincent Valentine character ecology for next Halloween, because his Halloween theme is... Anyways, without further ado, let's get to the next character ecology. Next character ecology being General Glocka. General Glocka, we don't know the exact age, but we can deter he's at least in his 50s. He's an older man. Because General Glocka is actually Tritus Dronatos, commander of the King's Glaive. Tritus Dronatos is a man who wants his home back. That's why he went into attacking Nyx and the rest of Insomnia. Under the apprentice's name of Glocka. And I said in my last video that is Tritus Dronatos General Glocka. Again, they're both the same body but different personalities. That you actually have to concur that they're different people. So we're gonna be focused on Glocka. So for Tritus Dronatos, we won't be mentioning him as much. This might be a separate video for Tritus Dronatos, but Dronatos is the body that inherits Glocka's personality. Glocka's armor is almost impenetrable. And the reason why in the movie, when Glocka took all those hits and still survived, because I have certain friends who are confused about that, his body is made of demons, high-class demons. You know the Iron Giants that you face at nighttime, all the Iron Giants? And you know how demons get stronger during nighttime. Well, if General Glocka's armor is made of high-class Iron Giant demons, that means General Glocka would be stronger than he naturally is during the day, because the armor is made out of those Iron Giants that you see you fight in the game. And hence why it was hard to kill Glocka until Nyx was figuring out that there's one fatal weakness. The human heart that Glocka has as Tritus Dronatos. Because without a personality's host, you're vulnerable. So thanks to Nyx figuring out where the heart is, no pun intended, that's how Nyx was able to defeat Glocka. But all those other hints that he had, just the incinerations, the thunders, the falls, and everything. The reason why Glocka is as strong as he is his armor is made of at least two Iron Giants and other high-class demons. Think of the material that's on Ravus's arm. You know the purple and silver material? It's the same material that's made out of General Glocka's armor. Except General Glocka's armor is full-body armor. So, Glocka is a little stronger than Ravus, because Ravus only got pieces of it for the arm. Glocka had the full entire armor, so it was harder to kill Glocka. That's why Glocka's been taking all those hits like it was nothing. That's how come it was hard to kill him after all that. And it just took one thing to the heart, which, you know, Nyx had to break up the armor that was protecting it. But the armor is protected by... You know, it is protected because it's like made out of Magitek, which if you know Magitek in Final Fantasy 15, it's armor and everything that's made out of demons. That Verstel, you know, Aranea hunts the demons out and brings the demons to the Niflheim Empire. Versteel, you know, takes all the dead demons and fuses it with metal, making new kind of metal. And the new kind of metal is actually Magitek. Everything that they make metal is made out of Magitek, but Glocka's Magitek armor is made out of the best. Meaning that Eidolus wanted to make the best soldier. Because no offense, Ravus is a good soldier, but Ravus still kind of has a heart. So it'd be kind of a hard time for him to do all the cold things that Glocka did, because when Glocka put the armor took over Titus Andronicus, and it was no longer Titus Andronicus, it was General Glocka. Even though Glocka was only trying to get his homes back, when he put the armor on, it changed his personality completely, so he became as evil as Arden, thanks to the armor. So the armor has special properties, besides just being strong. It also changes your personality as well. You know, that's why Ravus was a little meaner, because the metal arm was made by the same material that Glocka's, you know, that Glocka's armor's made out of. Which, ironically, because, well, Glocka's the one who killed Ravus's mother and turned Ravus into a trauma case, which made Ravus to what he is. So it's kind of ironic that they both use the same magitech for their stuff. Like, that arm that Ravus has is the same kind of magitech. That's why Ravus is stronger. It's the same kind of magitech that was used on General Glocka's armor. And the reason why this belongs in the character ecology. Now General Glocka's strength and power is the same as Nyx's. The same warp ability that Nyx knows. Since Titus Andronicus is in the armor suit of Glocka, Glocka has the defined teleport abilities and same abilities as Nyx Auric has, but 10 times stronger. And I guess they do this in Final Fantasy XV. I started seeing a pattern, because Arden can use Arbiter the same way Noctis could, but it's a more defensive, stronger version. Titus Andronicus, aka General Glocka, can use the same warp strike abilities as Nyx Auric, but 10 times stronger and more powerful. So he gets more powerful warp strikes. Hence why Glocka was strong enough to be able to kill King Regis. Yeah, King Regis was weakened. Now I'll admit, King Regis was weakened by the old war, which is the magic that King Regis used to use when he was on his journey. You know, so he couldn't fight the way he did. But even at King Regis's prime, when he was younger, Glocka would still be able to beat him on the fact that General Glocka's armor is made out of the strongest and most powerful demons found in Eos. You know. And made out of the strongest magitech, meaning that Eidolus wanted to have a soldier that was completely strong and heartless. Which he came to that because it took too much to kill Glocka. And that's why Glocka's so strong. And his speed is, I'd say, 10 times stronger than, as fast as the Nyx, because he's Titus Andronicus in the body of Glocka. So he knows more, since Titus Andronicus is the one who trained Nyx Auric. Obviously, Titus Andronicus would have the stronger version of that. But nonetheless, that's why this is the character ecology of General Glocka. One of the strongest Niflheim Empire generals ever. Like, he was revered even more than Aranea was and Ravus was. Like, Eidolus was proud of Glocka. And that's the character ecology of General Glocka. So may the crystal be with you. Like and subscribe, share, do all that fun stuff.
Can't keep my dick in my pants, ayy. My bitch don't love me no more, ayy. She kicked me out on life, bro.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah. Ayy. Yeah.